أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brother, sister, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. From Islamic Center of Reseda and the heart of Los Angeles, California, USA. This is your brother Sayyid Jum'a. We'll continue, inshallah, our interpretation of the Holy Quran. Inshallah, رب العالمين. We're still in Surah An-Nur, the chapter of the light. And we'll continue, inshallah. We talk tonight about the position of the hypocrites, the munafiqeen, and how Al-Quran Al-Kareem talks about them, how Rasulullah used to deal with them, and what these people they used to do for Islam or against Islam, against Islam. Because they show everybody in the community that they are Muslims, but inside their hearts they were not. They were against. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, verse number 47, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا ثم يتولى فريق منهم من بعد ذلك وما أولئك بالمؤمنين. The meaning here from Nur al-Bayan, the hypocrites would say, we have believed in Allah and in the Messenger and have adopted obedience. سمعنا ويقولون ايه؟ أطعنا. We have adopted obedience. We are obeying. Then a group from them goes back after all this. Those people are not believers at all. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showing us the reality of the hypocrites, the munafiqeen. Another ayah of Surah An-Nisa, the chapter of the women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. If they were being called to what Allah revealed to the Holy Quran and the Sunnah, وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ At Rasulullah's judgment, huh? رأيت المنافقين صدون عنك صدودا. You see the منافق, they are completely giving their backs to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they are rejecting others to come to Rasulullah too. فالمنافق, what is a منافق? منافق, somebody showing Islam to everybody but inside his heart he's a kafir, كفر. المنافق, he's not in the straight path. المنافق مضطرب متضارب كذاب he's a liar and سبحان الله contradicting himself why because the heart is full of disbelief كفر and the tongue saying the word of iman is not matching at all they are claiming الإيمان but والزعم the claims or claiming السمطية the right of those who are lying الكافر in the sight of Allah better than المنافق الكافر because he is منسجم يعني ايه الكافر already he declared he said I don't believe in Islam I don't believe in Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم فهو he declared his كفر disbelief but المنافق no منافق is hiding الكفر disbelief and showing الإيمان that's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the Holy Quran إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار. They're gonna be in the lowest of the low of hellfire. المنافقين. نعم. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in سورة المنافقون verse number one. إذا جاءك المنافقون when the منافقين the hypocrites they came to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم they said نشهد إنك لرسول الله we declare that you are رسول الله والله يعلم إنك لرسول الله. Allah knows that you are his messenger يا رسول الله. And look at this. والله يشهد. Allah is witnessing that the منافق, the hypocrites are liars. There is no contradiction in the verse. Why? Because they came, they said, يا رسول الله, you are رسول الله. And Allah knows رسول الله, محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is his messenger. But Allah said, the منافق, they are lying. Lying in what? Because they said with their tongue that رسول الله is رسول الله, but their heart against him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he sent this ayah verse number 47 because that incident happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A man his name was Bishr. That name or that man his name was Bishr. He was a munafiq, a hypocrite. He claimed that he is Muslim but he's kafir in reality. He was fighting with a Jewish guy, a Jewish man. And they said let's go take our judgment from Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf. Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf was a Jewish Jew. And what happened? And al-Yahudi, فرد al-Yahudi حكمه. And al-Yahudi the Jewish man, he was judging for the munafiq, the hypocrite. And the Jewish man said, no, let's go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to accept his judgment, to see what's his judgment. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his judgment was in the side of the Jewish man, not the munafiq Bishr. But what happened is, the munafiq, he did not accept the judgment of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because it was in the side of the Jewish guy. And they said, let's go to Umar ibn al-Khattab then. يعني first they went to Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf, يهودي, they did not accept the يهودي did not accept his judgment while he was Jewish like him. And they said, let's go to Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallam, he was in the side of the Jewish, the judgment of Rasulullah. And al-Munafiq, he did not accept it, Rasulullah's judgment. And they said, let's go to who's Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu wa'arda. Said, Umar, he was a judge. And said, Umar asked him, what did you do? He said, we came, Rasulullah, he said, so and so, we did not, munafiq man, the hypocrite, the Bishr. He said, I did not accept Rasulullah's judgment. And Sayyidina Umar, he get the sword. They said, you did not accept Rasulullah's judgment and you're coming to take my judgment. He get the sword and he showed to his face like this. He was about to kill him. And subhanAllah, فشهر السيفة في وجهه, he said, من لم يرضى بقضاء رسول الله فذلك قضاء فيه. Said Umar, said, if you did not accept Rasulullah's judgment, this is my judgment on you. I have to slaughter you. Said, but anyway, the munafiqin, they said, آمنا بالله وبالرسول. They said, we believe in Allah's oneness and we believe in Rasulullah as a Rasulullah, just by talking. But in reality, practically, no, they were lying. ثم يتولى فريق منهم, group of them, they turned their back and they ran away from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. They did not accept his judgment صلى الله عليه وسلم. وما أولئك بالمؤمنين, they are not مؤمنين. And because they refused the judgment of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these people, they are not mu'mineen, they are not believers. Why? Because they turn their back to the faith, to Islam, to Iman. But verse number 49. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still talking about the verse number 48 and 49, the position of the hypocrites. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ليحكم بينهم إذا فريق منهم معرضون وإن يكن لهم الحق يأتوا إليه مذعنين. And when they dispute together, Bishr and the Jewish guy, and they are called, summoned or called to what Allah and His Messenger ordained, in no time a group of them turns averse. Okay? But if the judgment is on their side, they will come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepting and showing submission. But because Rasulullah was in the side of Bishr, the munafiq, he rejected the judgment of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is what happened to Bishr and the Jewish guy. The munafiq man, the Bishr, the hypocrite, he rejected, he goes averse, and he did not accept the judgment of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Yahudi, the Jewish, accepted the judgment of Rasulullah. Why? Because he's mu'min? No. Because he loved Islam? No. Why he accepted the judgment of Rasulullah? Because Rasulullah was judging in his side. I am in my side. خلاص, I will accept it. Because it says for his maslaha, his own benefit. That's why. It is not because he's mu'min. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمِرْتَابُ. Verse number 50. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمِرْتَابُ أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Is it, Allah is asking, is it that their hearts are sick, ill, or they suffer from doubts about the messenger? That's called kufr al-riba, the kufr of doubt about Islam, about Allah, about Rasul. Or they feel that Allah and His Messenger would deal with them unjustly. أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ. Actually, بَلْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Actually, they are extremely unjust people. Look at this verse number 50 in Surah An-Nur. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. Is it in their hearts disease, sickness,
sickness of doubt, of the disbelief. What is the marad? المرض خروج الشيء عن استقامة سلامته. If you see any part of your body, like one of your organs, is not working anymore. Somebody is suffering from his eye, from his hearing, from his kidney, from his heart. This is called marad, sickness, illness. فالعين لها سلامة. If somebody is not seeing very well, it means he has sickness in his eye. And the اذن, he's hearing too, the same thing. سبحان الله. فالإنسان, he did not feel the importance of his organs and his body and while he's healthy. I think it's everything is going automatically. But when he lose one of his organs or he became sick and the complaining part of his body, now he recognizes the value of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to him. Subhanallah, imagine if somebody, مثلا, he's losing his kidney. His kidney, he was carried his kidney since Allah created him. And he did not care. He used to drink water and enjoying eating. But subhanallah, when he get that failure in his kidney, just to give an example, he recognized the value of his kidney. And he started showing millions of dollars or money for somebody can donate one of kidney to him just to keep him alive in this life. Otherwise, he gonna die one day. That's why we have to understand this, subhanallah. Allah said, أَمِرْتَابُ. These people, did they have any doubt of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And they scare from that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they deal with them unjustly. These people, first of all, ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. These people, they are ظَالِمِينَ. They are extremely unjust. Why? First of all, because they did ظلم against their own selves. And this is حمق وسفه. Do you know why? If you make ظلم, you are unjust against someone, might be you're going to get money or benefit or anything. But when you make ظلم against yourself, why? Because you are stupid. If somebody harming himself, what kind of benefit you do that? That's why these people, يعني سبحان الله, ما الخير في ظلم الإنسان نفسه. What kind of benefits the people they're going to get if they became unjust to themselves when they disobey Allah and they do something haram. Like for example, somebody is dealing with drugs and alcohol or gambling and he's losing his money, he's losing his health. That's why these people, subhanallah, يعني من ظلم نفسه لا تلوم من ظلم الآخرين. If he is unjust to himself, don't blame him if he's unjust to others too. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sometimes he punishes those who are unjust. This is for their own benefits, because if Allah is going to leave them just like that, these people, they will keep doing that and they will keep doing zulm against themselves and against others. But that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, because of the tariba, the doubt of al-kufr, these people, and they think that Allah and the Rasul, they will deal with them unjustly. This is zulm. This is not good. Verse number 51. إِنَّمَا كَانَ. Now you can see, you will see, that I have in my Tafsir Nur al-Bayan, the title for this ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني سبحان الله, الضد بالضد يعرف. When Allah talks about the munafiq, the hypocrites, and what they are doing, and that kind of doubt of kufr in their hearts, Allah now is talking about the believers too. You have to differentiate between what the believers are doing and the munafiq are doing. Very important. The obedience of the believers to Allah's judgment. When Allah judge in something or about something and the Rasul, they accept it immediately without any hesitation. Immediately. Verse number 51 in the chapter of the light. إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. The only reply to the true believers when they dispute and when they are called to Allah and His Messenger's judgment, they accepted with no doubt. The mu'min like this, they accepted with what? No doubt. Don't tell me it doesn't make sense because, and they put too many excuses. Yeah, Allah said under Rasul, that's it. It's muhkam. نص قطع للشهادة فيه. Be quiet. Allah talking to you under Rasul. That's it. Don't question. And they accepted because of their iman. Without any doubt. And they say, we listen and obey. سمعنا وأطعنا. Don't make like Jewish. سمعنا وعصينا. We listen and disobey. No. The مؤمن will say سمعنا وأطعنا. The مؤذان of the salah. الله أكبر الله أكبر. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. We listen and we obey. Huh? Whenever Allah is telling you something, we listen and we obey. This is a sign of your iman. Otherwise, if you say we listen and disobey, you have doubt in your heart. You have sickness in your heart. You're munafiq, a hypocrite. That's why look to the reply of the believers when any dispute happened and they being called to Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to judge between them, they accepted without any doubt. And they say, we listen and obey, and they are the successful ones. Look at this beautiful ayah. They are the successful ones. Look at this. I love even the tafsir I make it about this ayah. Because you come to Islam, to Iman, by your choice, right? Did anybody force you to be a Muslim? No. Did anybody force you to be a mu'min? No. You come to Islam, to Iman, by your choice. But that's why you have to respect your choice. See? To obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the one who choose to come to Islam. You are the one who choose to obey Allah. That's why respect your choice. Don't contradict yourself. I'm a Muslim, I'm a mu'min, then I have to go in this way. Why? Because this is my choice. Allah gave it to me and Allah, I'm going to use it in the right way. My choice to go to masjid. My choice to be a good Muslim. My choice to obey Allah. My choice to make the fara'id. My choice to show my goodness to Allah first and to the Muslims and to the whole entire world. That's why if you did not respect your choice, you are safi, fool. You are fooling yourself. Very important to know that. That's why al-mu'minun, they come to the point when they come to the dispute between themselves. And not like the munafiq and the Jewish guy. When they come to the dispute, what? When they will be called to Allah's Rasul, His judgment. Allah's and the Rasul, judgment. And they said, سمعنا, we listen and we obey. They respect their choice because they are mu'mineen. They come to Islam by their choice. فَيَقُولُ سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. See, this is the way. You are a Muslim, you are a mu'min, respect your choice. Very important to understand this. Look at this universe around you. SubhanAllah. Al-insan, Allah gives him the choice with al-jinn. But all the whole entire world, they come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without a choice. That's why Allah said in Surah Al-Ahzab, verse number 72, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَا أَيْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَأَشْفَقْنَا مِنْهَا. Allah showed the amana, the trust to السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ, to the heavens and to the earth and to the mountains. They said, Ya Rab, Allah give them a choice, huh? Are you gonna would you like to have a choice or do you want just to come to me with willingly or unwillingly? They said, Ya Rab, no, we don't need to have a choice, please. Allah gives them a choice for the first time. After that, they said, we don't need that choice. We're going to obey you. خلاص, that's it. But the insan, he relied on his brain and mind that Allah created to him. I said, I'm smart. And Allah gave them the choice. And they said, yes, I will carry the trust. And Allah said, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. He did oppress himself. He was unjust to himself. And he was ignorant of the responsibility of this trust. That's why Allah gave you the choice. يعني, the very important, al-munafiq, he rejected the judgment of Allah and the Rasul. The hypocrites, like that Bishr guy. And the mu'mineen, they said, we listen and we obey. سمعنا, we listen, we understand. And then we think, and then we answer, we obey. Not just we are not listening just like that. No. We listen, we understand what Allah is telling us. We understand it very well, and we obey, we practice our Islam. That's why Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter of the table, number 5 in the Holy Quran, verse number 83, Allah said, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ. When the believers, they listen to the Quran, whatever Allah revealed to Rasul, ترى أعينهم تفيض من الدمع مما عرفوا من الحق. You see their eyes full of tears because Allah seen the truth, the Quran al-Kareem. The mu'min, when he listens to the Quran, he tears. Goes bomb, skin, tear of Allah Azza wa Jal. يعني calmness, you know. That's why when we come to the salah, from when we stand from bowing, ruku', The Imam say, سمع الله لمن حمده. Allah hears or he's hearing those who are praising him. Say, سمع الله لمن حمده. Means Allah, he's answering those who are praising him. سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا لك الحمد. All praise and thanks are due to Allah, our Lord. In the hour salah. That's what he said. Allah said, وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Those people, they are the successful ones. الفائزون. Those who come to the level of الفلاح, success. And الفلاح comes from الفلاح, cousin bad. What الفلاح is doing? الفلاح is putting one seed under the ground, the soil, inside the soil. And what happened? That one seed, بذرة, will give him 700. In each year, just 700 like this. Allah said it. To كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. يعني 700. If the earth, the soil, is giving you 701, you put one is giving you 700. What about Allah, the one who created the earth? What he gonna give you? I'm sure more. I'm sure more. Allah will give it to you. That's why you have to understand this. عطاء الله. Allah is a bestower without حساب. يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Allah wanna give you without any accountability. طيب. Verse number 52. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَى اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقِهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. I love this ayah so much. Some scholars, they said this ayah is a message. It's a title for all Muslims. It's a way of life. It's enough for you. It's enough for Muslims. If you understand this ayah and you follow it, it's enough, more than enough for you. You don't need any Quran after that. You don't need anything. What's the ayah saying? And whoever obeys Allah and his messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and has fear of Allah, الخشية. الخشية more than the fear of Allah. Fear of Allah, تقوى الله. But الخشية, like سيدنا إبراهيم, and he has of him, and he fears him, ويتقه, and he keeps his duty to him. تقوى, this is the meaning of تقوى. See, everybody, when they translate the word of تقوى, they say fear of Allah, but explain it different. التقوى means to keep your duty to Allah as a Muslim, and he keeps his duty to Allah, such are the successful ones. Look at this ayah, number 52 in Surah Al-Nur, the chapter of Al-Nur. It's a message from Allah. Allah summarized the whole entire Quran and messages in this ayah. And the whole entire revelation, Quran, and the Sunnah in this ayah. Man amana billah, whosoever or whoever obeys Allah and believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and obeys Allah, after he iman, he obeys Allah, and he also obeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he has and the fear of Allah, and he's keeping his duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and wa yakhaf Allah, and he has the fear of Allah for what? That sin, or this sin, this or those sin he committed before. He still remember, whenever he remember his sin, he get that fear in his heart. Wa yattaqih, what's wa yattaqih? And also he has the awe of the sins he did before. Wa yattaqih means in the future, the rest of his life, he has the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you remember your sin, you have the awe and the fear of Allah. And you fear Allah, you keep your duty to Allah the rest of your life, these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them amongst those who are successful, inshallah, rabbil alameen. طيب, let's go verse number 53, and I have a title again. After Allah talks about the hypocrisy and the people of hypocrisy, and how they rejected the judgment of Allah and the Rasul. So Allah talks in these two ayat about the mu'mineen, verse number 51-52. Now Allah comes back to the hypocrites. Why? Allah is going to taking you sometimes to munafiqeen, hypocrites, then to the mu'mineen, then to the hypocrites. Why? Because Allah showed you the two opposite things. When you give two opposite things now in front of you, you're going to see this is salt and this is sugar. This is honey and this is pepper. This is Jahannam and this is hellfire. Now the picture will be declared to your mind, right? You're going to see this is munafiq and what he's doing, and this is the mu'min, what he's doing. This is the reward of the mu'min, and this is the punishment of the munafiq. That's why Allah takes you to the hypocrisy,
then to the mu'mineen. Now he's taking you to the munafiq again. The hypocrites lies in their obedience to Allah's judgment. Verse number 53. وَأَقَسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَهْدَ أَيْمَنِهِمْ لَإِنْ أَمَرْتَهُمْ لَيَخْرُجُونَ قُلْ لَا تُقْسِمُوا طَاعَةٌ مَعْرُوفَةٌ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خربانين. They swear by Allah. They are Rasulullah, when you go to jihad, we're going to leave our family, our money, our kids, we're going to come with you. Allah said, don't swear. I know what you're going to do. Obedience, your obedience is known to me. Allah said that. You're lying. And this is what happened in the Battle of Uhud. They said to Rasulullah, we're going to come with you. We are in the first line. And Abdullah ibn Salul, they left Rasulullah fighting and they went back to Medina. Look what they said. The hypocrites swear to Allah by their strong oath. Do you know أقسم لجهد أيمن إيزي? What's wrong with us? They did not swear by their fathers, mothers, whatever. They swore by Allah. This is the strongest oath. That's why Rasulullah, if you want to swear, swear by Allah. This is the strongest oath. Yes, don't say we said al-Badawi, al-Husayn, al-Jalani, al-Battikh. Forget about these sheikhs and Battikh. No. So if you want to swear by Allah. Otherwise, you're going to commit shirk. This is shirk. Don't tell me we said al-Badawi, al-Jalani, al-Sayyid al-Zainab, al-Husayn. All of this shirk, haram. If you want to swear, say billahi wallahi tallahi. This is a qasam in Islam. And don't use it too much. Okay? These people. And when you see somebody swearing all the time, even without you ask him, it means he's lying. Allah said that فَلَا تُطْعُ وَلَا تُطْعُ كُلِّ حَلَّافٍ مَهِينٍ هَمَّازٍ مَشَّيْنْ بِنَمِيمٍ. Everybody's swearing all the time. He's, don't obey him. Don't listen to him. Allah said that. He's lying. You know? الْحَرَمَ حْلِفْ أَلْقَلَكِ الْفَرَقْ. When the judge told the thief, swear, and the thief starts smiling. Why? He said, now he's gonna really let me go because I swear. See, he's lying. Yes. Anyway, if you command after they swear them for a defensive war, they will certainly march forth. Say, do not swear. Only reasonable obedience is required from you. Allah said, and you are just saying that by your tongue. And the reality of your obedience is known to Allah. They're lying. Indeed, Allah knows all of what you do. This is exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about, these hypocrites. They lie all the time. Islam is not just by talking, jama'ah. That's very important to understand this. Allah knows what's in their hearts. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed their shame to the community. You're going to hide it? Allah will show it second day. Jibril came to Rasulullah with the Quran, showing their shame to the community. Allah said, your obedience is known to Allah Azza wa Jal. You are just mu'minin by your tongue. إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Allah knows what's in your hearts, what's in your mind. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني these people, they disappointed the Rasul and the Sahaba too many times. And Islam is still giving them too many ways, chances to come back to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Look at this ayah, last ayah with me today, verse number 54. Allah is still opening the doors for them. Even they disappointed Rasulullah too many times. The hypocrites. The obedience of the believers to Allah's judgment. Look at this ayat. قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Again, فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِمَا حُمِّلَ وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ وَإِنْ تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ. Beautiful ayat. So, O Prophet, tell them, tell whom? To the hypocrites. Because, why Rasulullah is telling them? Because they used to pray with Rasulullah in the masjid. Their tongue saying the word of Islam, Al-Iman, but their hearts disbelief, full of kufr. They are against Islam. And Allah still, after all of this, too many times they disappointed Rasul and the Sahaba in the war and in Medina, and they were against Islam. They were stabbing the Islam from its back all the time. And Allah still opening the doors of Tawbah to them. Tell them, Ya Rasulullah, obey Allah and obey His Messenger. But if you turn away, then remember that the messenger is responsible for his mission to deliver the da'wah. And you people are responsible for applying his orders to obey Allah. Truly, if you obey him, Rasulullah, you will be following the right path. And the Prophet's mission is to relay Allah's message, to call people to Allah's message, that's all, to deliver the message to you clearly. This is the message of Rasulullah. Rasulullah is not responsible for your hidayah.
Otherwise, why he did not guide his uncle Abu Talib? His uncle Abu Talib died as a kafir. And the same thing said Ibrahim with his father Azar. Same thing Sayyidina Nuh and Lut with his wives and with his son Sayyidina Nuh. See, these Anbiya, they could, Adam with his son Qabil, he killed his brother. See, these Anbiya, they were not able to guide their families. That's why Rasulullah, Allah told him, Ya Rasulullah, don't be sad. Too many times Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was very sad because he wants everybody to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal, when these people or others or us make tawbah, repentance to Allah, Allah will be so happy for his tawbah. That's why for this ayat, what I collected for you, especially those who are called them, the sect, they call themselves Quraniyin, those who are denying the Sunnah. Look what Allah is saying, Ya Mr. Qurani, Ya Ghabi, Ya Abit, Ya Ahbal, Mr. Stupid. Look what Allah is telling you, don't deny Sunnah. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. In this ayah, obey Allah and obey Rasul. طيب. And he said, وَمَنْ يُطِعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Surah An-Nur, verse 52. And whoever obeys Allah and his Rasul. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Surah Al-Anfal, verse number 20. أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Obey Allah and his messenger. And Surah An-Nisa, the chapter of the women, verse number 80. مَنْ يُطِعُ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ Allahu Akbar. Look at this ayah. Whosoever obeys Rasul, he's obeying Allah. See? فالرسول مشرع. أيوة. أي If you obey Rasul, means you are obeying Allah, means it's one obedience. If you obey Allah, means you obey Rasul. If you obey Rasul, means you obey Allah. And now this Quran, you will like, لا يا أخي, Quran is enough. We don't need Sunnah. يا عبيت يا هبل. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hashr, in chapter of Al-Hashr, verse number 7, He said, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا Whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives you, And he's ordering you, take it immediately. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا Listen and obey. And whatever he forbids you, just abstain, be away from it. Means Rasul Musharri'a, Rasul is the one who's putting the Sharia for us. Allah told, Allah give him this authority. وَمَا أَتَاكُمْ رَسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ Oh, Brother Ahmed Kabir is giving me any gift, something. And Allah said, take it from him. I'm gonna make arguments with him. I can say no because I don't like it. No, take it. That's it, it's order. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ Take it, that's it. Now we're like, لا. فالقرآن, why? Because the Quran مجمل. أحكام القرآن مجملة. يعني مجملة is not explained. Not in details. Not too many analysis about it. But الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he came with his sunnah to explain this آيات الأحكام المجملة. التفصيل. The explanation. For example, الصلاة, Allah said, establish salah and make the salah. How do you know salat al-fajr two rak'ahs, al-isha four rak'ahs? Who told us about this? Rasulullah, right? يبقى now, Al-Quran ayat muhkama, mujmala, and Rasul, he explained that ayat. For Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was very, really, his صلى الله عليه وسلم, his mission was to bring everybody to the mercy of Allah and the hidayah. That's why Allah said to him, لَعَلَّكَ بَيْخَعُ نَفْسَكَ لَيَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ Don't be sad, Ya Rasulullah, because they disobeyed you. Your job is to deliver the message. إِنْ عَلَيْكَ إِلَّا الْبَلَاءُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said again, after what these hypocrites did against Islam and against you, call them for second time, Rasulullah. Give them a chance. قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ Tell them, obey Allah and obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in the end, Allah said, if you disobey Allah and the Rasul, فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِمَا حُمِّلْ يعني what's عَلَيْهِمَا حُمِّلْ The message of Rasulullah to deliver the da'wah. That's it. This is he relied the da'wah to you. That's it. He's calling you to Allah. وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ Your responsibility to obey him. And his responsibility, صلى الله عليه وسلم, to deliver the da'wah. That's it. عَلَيْكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا مَا كُلِّفْتُمْ الدين, obey. وَإِن تُطِيعُوا تَهْتَدُوا If you obey Rasulullah, you will be guided. فَالطَّاعَ وَاحِدَة Same obedience. مَنْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ الرَّسُولُ وَمَنْ أَطَاعَ الرَّسُولُ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولُ تَكْلِيفُ الرَّسُولُ مُكَلَّفُ to deliver the message. His job, mission, takleef to deliver the message clearly. And your responsibility, your job to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah is the one who gave us all the sharia and the manhaj al-tashri'i for fixing our life and for the happiness of our life as a way of life. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be good Muslims, to follow the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, suratan wa sarira.
فاللهم يا رب العالمين ثبتنا على الهدى وعلى الإيمان واجعلنا ممن يتبعون القرآن والسنة يا أرحم الراحمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.